Welcome back. So we are hearing a lot about doctors and nurses' efforts, their incredible efforts to fight COVID-19. But respiratory therapists are one of the front lines tasked with putting patients on ventilators. And Myron Drissen is a respiratory therapist at the Cleveland Clinic. He's at the main campus, and he's joining us this morning with the very latest. And Myron, thank you for being with us today. In your career, I know you've been at the clinic for 8 years and all of your studies in previous places that you've been. Have you ever seen anything quite like you have seen in the last 2 months?
No, not at all. And I don't think anybody has really seen anything like this or can be prepared for something on such a major level. So, but we're truly doing the best we can. And the Cleveland Clinic has really prepared us for every situation that we're finding ourselves into.
Give us an idea, if you would, of what's involved when you have to put a patient on a ventilator.
Yeah, so the first thing's gonna be, with these patients, we're talking a lot about safety and protection, and not only for our patients, but now for our healthcare workers as well. So with that being said, when we talk about putting an airway tube in a patient, a breathing tube, we are talking about one of the procedures that puts you in the highest risk for being exposed. So a lot of the planning starts outside of the patient's room. So we really want to decrease the time that we're in the room and how many people are going into the room. So we kind of have a timeout and huddle, and we talk about all the procedures, equipment, and all the specific things that everybody's doing before we go into the room. And we have a plan. So if plan A doesn't work, we go to plan B. So we're not inside the room going through everything. So from there, then we'll go into the respiratory therapist will enter the room. He'll get all the equipment ready for the patient. The rest of the team will follow in. And then from there, we will proceed with the intubation. Once the tube is in the correct place and we put the patient safely on the ventilator, we'll have another therapist outside of the room who's controlling the vent. They'll set appropriate settings that are safe and protected for the specific patient that we're putting on the ventilator.
And they are awake. The patient is awake throughout this procedure. Is that correct?
No, we'll keep them sedated and comfortable through it, so they won't feel anything that's going on.
And then taking them off, you know, we keep hearing these dismal conversations and comments from a lot of doctors saying once a patient has to be on a ventilator, it's not that easy to get them off of it and kind of increases their chances of dying. Tell us a little bit about that and why that is.
So, you know, when these patients start to get better, it's not like they wake up and we're like, okay, we'll take them off the ventilator. Normally with prolonged ventilation, we see where the respiratory muscles are kind of fatigued and they take a little time to, rehab back. So the patient's normally awake, talking to you, and then, you know, with nursing staff, physical therapy, occupational therapy, we all work as a team. And then once the patient's strong enough, then we're able to get that tube out. And that is a truly a gratifying day for not only the patient, but for the healthcare workers as well. And, that's definitely the mode of the patients are so grateful. And, they could be on the ventilator for, 2 to 3 weeks. So when that tube finally does come out, they're so appreciative of all the hard work that we did. And that's really, what keeps you driving to, keep coming to work, doing the same thing, passionate about your work. So,
well, Myron Drissen, we thank you for taking time out of your schedule at work to talk with us. And I know in our chat during commercial break, right before our interview, you also said you've never seen anything like it, seeing everyone, your coworkers, and all of the people at the hospital come together. And that kind of gives you goosebumps and chills because you guys are experiencing something like you've never seen before.
Yeah. Yep. And then just one other thing about the app, the ventilator mode map app, with all this through this pandemic, with all the different ventilators that are going throughout the hospitals that some therapists have never seen before. Respiratory therapist at the clinic, Rob Chapman, and the programmers here have developed this app, and it makes it easy. If you've never seen that ventilator before, you can easily go through and see what modes are compatible with different ventilators that you've not have used before. So you could download that app, and it's free as well.
And it's called what, Myron?
Ventilator Mode Map.
Okay, great. Thanks for the information. Appreciate it. Stay safe. You are on the front lines, and thank you for what you are doing in saving lives.
Thank you so much.
Every day, Myron. Thank you so much. Appreciate it.